Good evening. My name is Robert Szendrey, and I am honored and privileged to be speaking with you all on behalf of many family members of fallen firefighters, police officers, and EMS personnel. Just a bit about myself. I am an EMT with the FDNY. I've been with the FDNY going on 6 years, most of which has been spent at Station 49 in Astoria, Queens. My stepfather, firefighter Raymond York, of Engine Company 285 in Ozone Park, Queens, was killed on September 11th. This past year has been an especially difficult year. The 20th anniversary of September 11th, 2001, along with the COVID-19 pandemic. It's been a year of hardships and difficulties on us all. Though this was the year I saw firsthand the heroism, the bravery, and resiliency of every first responder and healthcare worker out on the front lines, away from their families, fighting an unknown and evolving battle, a battle much different than was faced by so many 20 years ago, but a battle that brought out the extraordinary in ordinary people, just like that day 20 years ago. My dad's story begins in March of 1982 when he was assigned to 21 Engine in Midtown Manhattan. It was there that he met and befriended my uncle, retired Lieutenant Billy Abrazino, one of my mother's three firefighting brothers. Not many guys in the firehouse would be worthy of dating your sister, but Ray York was a different kind. When my uncle introduced them, they immediately hit it off. Before they were even married, my stepfather took on the role of dad to three kids, in addition to his own daughter. He was a Boy Scout leader, a Little League coach, and a role model, without ever being asked or expected to be. My dad had three true passions in his life: his family, the FDNY, and the New York Yankees, where on any given night he could be heard doing his best John Sterling impression, shouting, "The Yankees win, the Yankees win," around the house, much to my mother's dismay. She's also a Mets fan, so I'm sure that adds to it. The last week of August, leading up to Labor Day, every year is spent with family in the Poconos, a tradition that has happened in my family for almost 40 years. In August of 2001, that was no different. We barbecued, we fished, we swam. We watched Yankees pitcher Mike Mussina take a perfect game into the ninth inning, only to lose it with two outs. The date was September 2nd. Earlier that day, we had picked my dad up at a bus stop a town away. You see, my dad had traveled back to New York for the funeral of firefighter Michael Garumba of Engine Company 163, who died while fighting a fire on Staten Island. My dad took pride in the fact that in his nearly 20 years of service to the city of New York, he never missed a funeral for a firefighter killed in the line of duty. That weekend, his three passions were on full display, and it's something I remember vividly and will never forget. In early 2000, my dad severely injured his shoulder while on duty and had to undergo surgery. During his recovery, he found himself on what we call light duty, working at the fire zone in Rockefeller Center, teaching children about fire safety as Fireman Ray. Being a big kid and a knowledgeable firefighter, it was a role he needed no practice for. He fit right in and always went above and beyond to share his passion with others, including getting the quartermaster to make kid-sized firefighting turnout coats so kids who visited could have the best possible experience. On his days off, he could be found enjoying his newfound therapeutic hobby of kayaking, something he had no experience whatsoever doing, but still insisted on the longest and most dangerous kayaking trips, which he did all around New York City with many of his firefighting buddies. The last couple of days I spent with my dad were my 11th birthday on September 9th. We spent that day with my uncle and my cousin at their house eating pizza and watching the Jets kick off their season to a 45-24 loss to the Colts, a thing most Jets fans have become accustomed to. The next day, Monday, September 10th, was my first day of sixth grade, the day my dad drove down to FDNY headquarters with a neighbor of ours, who was also a firefighter, to put in their retirement papers. The tentative date was October 1st, 2001. That night, we waited to watch Roger Clemens go for his 20th win, but the game was ultimately rained out. The morning of Tuesday, September 11th, was a beautiful sunny day, without a cloud in the sky. It was supposed to be the start of a major kayaking trip around the island of Manhattan, like I said, dangerous and long, launching from Battery Park. But last minute, he rescheduled the trip because there was a news crew coming into the fire zone that day. My dad, never being one to miss the opportunity to be the center of attention, had to be there. When news broke that the World Trade Center was hit by an airplane, The news crew had no choice but to be where the bigger story was downtown. My dad was along for the ride. When they got stuck in traffic, he flagged a passing ambulance that took him right down to West Street. When the North Tower came down, my dad, like so many others, died a hero. He was last seen running into the lobby of One World Trade Center and was found in the early morning of September 12th, a phone call we got as we were preparing for school the next morning. In the now 20 years since 9/11, I've heard countless stories of my dad and so many others. But just when I thought I heard them all, I was told a story from a group of firefighters who credit my dad with most likely saving their lives on September 11th by simply rescheduling a kayaking trip. I'm proud to have followed in his footsteps by serving others. For me, it was my way of keeping his memory close to me, and it started a passion and legacy I hope to continue. As a surviving family member, I know what a difference Answer the Call makes in the lives of families like mine. The events they host, like the Annual Gala, Family Day at Citi Field, the Red and Blue Soiree, countless golf outings, have allowed us to connect with other families who have suffered similar losses. There is a bond we have like no other. Through these events, we have made lasting friendships and family, and I know we are never alone on our journey. Since 2001, Answer the Call has been a source of support for my family. In addition to the social events, they have provided financial assistance from day one and continue to do so every year. They have made a lifetime commitment to us, and we are forever grateful. In less than a year's time, I myself will be getting married to my beautiful fiance, Jean Marie, who's here with me tonight. She's the one over there, her face is all red. After experiencing firsthand how Answer the Call has helped my mother, my siblings, and I all these years, I am extremely grateful to know that if my wife and kids were ever in a similar situation, Answer the Call would always be there for them. I know I speak for my family and every other family they've helped before and after my own when I say thank you to Answer the Call and thank you to generous people like all of you who have continually supported them and make opportunities like this possible for families in need of assistance. Thank you.